Okay, this is just a small tutorial on how to play video from one of these. These are DDS3 tapes. Normally they are used for backup purposes. And yeah, they are nearly identical to DAT tape, but a bit thinner. You can actually use these on your DAT machine, although this is not supported, but it might work. But for this video, we will use them the way they are intended. Well, a bit like they were intended. First, we put it into a PC, into the corresponding drive. But we won't be doing backups today. That's a bit, that's not as intended, because I just thought, wouldn't it be cool to store video on these and stream it from them? And yeah, this is actually totally possible. All we need to do in the first place is to write video to them. And let me take a look. I did a few tests before. This would be the way to play it back. I will explain later how that goes. But let's see, where did I have it? Yeah, that's the way I write it to the disk. I take my MKV video. It's really important that you use MKV, because this is the only container format that doesn't really have restrictions on how you play it, because an MP4 file, for example, is really, really picky about its headers and so on, and you can't stream it without issues, and you can't start it from in the middle, which is totally fine with MKV. So we cat this file, then we send it to PV just to get a status progress, and then we buffer it out to the tape drive. Note that I'm using devnst0 and not devst0. That's because with this method the drive isn't rewound after recording. So I can then put another video after it. It works totally fine without tar, because even in that case, on the end of the MKV, there's an EOF header. And so you can skip through these with mt-f, then device, and then fsf1. And then you can move from video to video. But in this case, we just rewind the tape, which it already is, so nothing will happen. Yeah. And let's play it now. And let me quickly say, here we go. What I actually do, okay, we don't need this video output option here, actually. I read it buffered directly from the tape drive, directly from the tape, and pipe it just to mPlayer and tell mPlayer, hey mPlayer, please play STD in. So everything that's piped. And if we now press enter, our drive will start to make noises, and we will see that mPlayer is reading from stdin, and this takes a bit, because yeah, all the headers and so on, yeah, it's MKV after all, but yeah, takes a moment. And now if we click here, here's our video directly streamed from the tape. Yeah, that's actually live streaming. You see it here in the blinking interval of the drive. It always fetches a bit into the buffer, a few kilobytes, and then these are played. But you won't recognize any of this. It goes totally smooth. And if I would have speakers connected to this machine, I would also hear the audio. Because, yeah, it's included. It's a normal MKV file that I'm streaming here. And works totally fine. I can view my video, and yeah, what's really funky about these is the capacity. Is it written on this one? Let's see. No, it isn't, but they are marketed as 24 gigabyte cassettes. Well, actually they are 12 gigabyte, but with compression you could get a lot more on it, and that's what the manufacturer is talking about with the 24 gigabytes. So this MKV file contains It contains H.264 video, which already is compressed, so we can't compress it any further, so 12 gigabyte is our limit. But with 12 gigabyte you get quite an amount of video per tape, and yeah, you can go with any quality you want, because yeah, it's just digital data. I just used this low resolution and also this TWM window manager instead of something fancy, because this is an old Pentium 3 machine, and yeah, H.264 is a bit taxing for these systems. They were never meant to do something like that, but you could use other codecs and then you can go higher resolutions. Now we can quickly take a look on the load, and you can see, yeah, we are at around 50% CPU load, so yeah, it does what it should, but you should be a bit picky about the resolution. Okay, and that's all I wanted to show at the moment. Just one test I want to do. I now stopped the playback via Control C, but didn't rewind the tape. So if I now do this again, it should continue where it left off. No, it can't. So that's not possible, although MKV supports that. So we need to rewind the tape. I don't know why, because MKV should support that. Maybe because of the headers that the drive itself is looking for. And after we rewound it, we can now type eject and wait a bit for the drive. Yeah. Come on, drive, you can do it. Just a bit. Yeah. It isn't the fastest medium in terms of that. But here we go. Here we go. Something happened. Shouldn't take that long from now on. Come on, give me my cassette. So these drives are really slow in outputting the tape. Yeah, it's doing something, but I don't know what. Come on. Ah. But it's totally normal. They take their time. And here we go. Here's our cassette. And yeah, that's the video I put on. Let's see how big it is. I think 11 megabyte or so. Nothing. Oh, maybe I should. So now you can read it. let's see. I got the file here. Yeah, 11 megabyte. And let's see if we can get some more information about it. Okay, no. This old version of the file command doesn't know how to query this information. Because, yeah, that's a really old Debian 6 install here, Debian Squeeze. But it's matching to the hardware a bit, I guess. But yeah, that's all I wanted to show. It's totally possible to stream videos from DPS3 tape drives. And this method should work for all other types of tape drives too, because yeah, Linux treats them all the same. So you could also do it on LTO and so on, if you got one of these. Yeah, and these cassettes are just awesome. Just wanted to say that. Okay, see you soon. Bye.